My name is Abby Chamberlin. I am a junior at Forsyth High School, and this is what I want my legacy to be in 100 years. Virtually my whole life, I have lived with my mother and gone to see my dad on the weekends. I was 2 years old when my parents got divorced, and because of that, I have no real memory of them being together. Even though they can't always be there for me at the same time, they have been the most loving and supportive parents anyone could ask for. My parents are the most caring people I have ever met, but as a kid, neither one of them went to church on a regular basis. However, my whole life I have known that my granny goes to church every Sunday that she's able to. She goes to a little church called Victor Baptist. When I was in around third grade, my mom moved us into her boyfriend at the time's house. It was a very long few years for me as a child. My mom didn't know it, but I was very miserable. While I was there, I didn't have what I was used to having. People told me that it was just hard for me because I had to share my mom with other people and I wasn't used to doing that. But it was a lot more than just that. While I was there, I watched my mom get yelled at. I saw her doing the yelling, and for the only time in my life, I saw her cry. It was hard for me as a little girl to see my mom cry like that, and then have to go back into that house and do it all over again. That was when I realized that I needed Jesus. I knew that I couldn't do this on my own, and that the only way I could deal with this situation was to give it to God and let Him have control of my life. There was nothing else I could do but give my life to Him. As I have gotten older, I found a little church close to my house called Hilltop Church. There, they have a small youth group and a very close-knit family that takes up about a third of the population of the church or more. Every year, I go to the church camp that they have during the summer. That is where I really found Jesus, and I found people that I could look up to as a godly example. Because of the struggles I have faced in my life, my main goal is to learn from them. I want to be an example for the people who look up to me. My little cousins, Emma, Ella, and Eva, are growing up seeing me and watching me go through life. These girls are one of the most important parts of my life, and even though their parents always take them to church and teach them about Jesus, I want to be the one that they can always look up to as almost a big sister. As I think about what I want people to remember about me in 100 years, I have decided that I don't actually want people to remember me at all. I want my legacy to be of God's love and His mercy. I want to be remembered for putting myself aside and letting Jesus shine through me. I don't want to be remembered for who I was, but for who lived inside of me. And I